One problem of the balls. We have a situation where we have a box contains one yellow, two red, three green balls. Two balls are randomly chosen without replacement to find the following events. So I'm just going to define two events for this example. Event A is one of the balls is yellow. One ball is yellow. Event B is at least one ball is red. Right. And that's what I'm going to do to write here. Then I'm going to say we have the information we have is we have one yellow, two red, three green. Right. Now, the first thing sometimes it's asked is, well, is it exactly one ball is yellow, or at least one ball is yellow? In this case, it doesn't matter because we have one. Right? Okay. So there's two, and the question is, so now we have all the information. The question is, what's the probability? Actually, I'm going to do a different question now. It's a little bit easy to illustrate. What's the probability of A given B? How do I find this out? So now I'm set. What do I do? Well, the first thing you want to do is figure out the algebra. So I can either write this as Bayes' theorem, or I can use the conditional definition, which is just the product rule we've written, and that would give me A and B divided by probability of B. So I'm actually going to do this problem two different ways. One way is the algebraic way, which is what you did using combinations. You don't even have to use combinations. You can actually kind of, you know, let's say eyeball this kind of problem, but you end up, it's equivalent to that. That's one way to do it. You can actually count all the scenarios up. Algebra will never fail you. The problem with this particular one is that it's such a simple problem, and I emphasize that, that you can do it using pictures a little bit easier than you can with the algebra. The problem is pictures fail you eventually. Algebra doesn't. So just to make that free. So now, the conceptual way to do this, you can actually draw a Venn diagram with this. The Venn diagram I'm going to draw is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And these are all the combinations. This is going to be all the different ways we can have red and green balls together. And this is first ball. And this is the second ball. So now I'm going to say, okay, let's put in my colors. So I have green, green, green. There's three of those. Green 1, green 2, green 3. Green 1, green 2, green 3. And I have reds, two reds. Red 1, red 2, red 1, red 2. I have one yellow, which I'm going to represent as blue, if I don't have it. Okay. So now, the first thing is, what are all the combinations of two balls that I can get? Well, can I get two yellow? No, because I only have one yellow, so that's not a possibility. I also, because I have without replacement, I cannot get the same ball twice, and so I rule out all of those possibilities. So I had 36 squares open, now I have 30. And therefore, all my possibilities that I can ever have is 30. Okay. So that's the number of ways I can get two balls, 30, right? Now, If I want to answer this, I can answer it two ways. Let's do it the algebraic way first. What's the probability of A and B? Well, first of all, I got to mark where B is. If B is at least one red, and one red I'm going to make a circle with. So where can I get one red? Well, I can have a yellow with red one. I can have a yellow with red two. And so I can also have two reds, red one and red two, because it's at least one red. And of course, that's true too. And so all of this row, I can have reds. And all the other row, these are all other possible combinations I can have. So those, that is B. What I just drew with circles are all the possibilities for B. So now, anyway, so right away I can draw right with the probability of B. Probability of B is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 18 red circles. So that means I have 18 ways of getting B, at least one red, divided by total number, which is 9. Now I got to find A and B. So where are all the A's? So the A I'm using as blue. So now I'll make a slash for the A. So where do I have one ball that's yellow? Well, those all have yellows. Those all have one yellow, correct? But I need red, at least one red and yellow. So I have to find where are the red circles and a slash. You see, there are four. Right? And so therefore, I have 4 out of 30. So the probability of A and B, the intersection, is 4 out of 30, which gives me a grand total of 4 out of 18. This is the best way to do this problem because it builds intuition on how you do this. Now, I could have done it with Bayes as well. I could have said, what's the probability of A? And then I look at all the A's, just like I did this. And what's the probability of B given A? How do I do that? Well, I'm going to show you that by doing the problem I'm using. This particular problem, you do. What does it mean when I say the probability of A given B? It means that all the B's, what's the probability of getting A out of the B? Given B is true. So if I go back here and I say, out of all the B's, out of all the red circles, where are the A's? In other words, where are the yellow balls? Well, here, 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 and here. Out of all the circles, where are the yellow balls? Just there. And that's 4, right? That's 4 of those, just like we had over here, but out of how many? No, because 30 is the total amount. Out of all the circles, which is all the B's, 18. 4 out of 18. Given that it's a B, that means out of just the B's, what's the probability of getting A out of the B? 4 out of 18. And of course, 4 out of 18. Yeah. Yeah, algebra will always say the way we did it is a better way to do it. But this is one way to at least visualize it and check the answer. Cool?